After 3 grueling weeks and countless blocks of chocolate, Australia's first ever dessert master has been crowned.
Gareth, your first course was almost faultless. And so was your second course. I gave you both 9. You are our Australian dessert master.
Would you please welcome Gareth Whitton? A moment, the very first dessert master. How does it feel? How sweet does it feel?
Yeah, it's pretty wild. It was a it was an incredible experience. Like the whole filming of it was amazing. We made some incredible contacts, some great friends. Yeah, and then obviously to walk away with the chocolates at the end was that was a pretty surreal moment.
Now, one of your winning dishes, the rhubarb tart, was almost your downfall. I can relate. The amount of times the rhubarb tarts almost brought me down in my prime. Were you worried about it?
I mean, you know, the rhubarb was poached in this grenadine, which is obviously like a really deep red. So I was kind of hoping that I'd get away with all the amount of blood that made it into the rhubarb soup to begin with. So, if anything, it kind of made the dish pop a little bit more. But, to be honest, I just needed to get a glove on it. It was, it's very commonplace in kichens when you make a bit of a boo-boo and you got yourself bleeding. You just need to basically get a barrier between the blood and the plate and then try and carry on. But, you know, with the magic of television, they managed to really make a bit of a song and dance, get the medic out on set. And
yeah, we got rid of Sam's blood nose tonight.
Yeah. They did make a song and dance when someone bleeds on television. I've learned that from experience.
Yeah, but note to self, never order the red dish. Gareth, you are known as the tart guy. A couple of tart girls sitting over here. So we feel like, you know...
We know.
There's
we
a
know.
Bit going on. You've got your tarts and non... T-shirt on.
Yep.
Did you go into the competition thinking that the tarts were your strong point and you would make a tart if you had to, was it your go-to dish? Or did you try and stay away from it?
No, not at all. I think the idea was to really showcase, because I think we have got ourselves a bit of a reputation as being, you know, tart people, because it's literally our thing, is what we do.
If you call yourself Tarts and Nine, I reckon people are
exactly. Yeah. It's a bit of a giveaway. I have years and years of experience in fine dining restaurants, and I feel like that message has been lost somewhat through the success of our business. So it's a double-edged sword. But coming onto the show, really, my intention was to try and showcase a bit of other skill and like things that I'd learned throughout years working, you know, with Heston and Peter Gilmore and, you know, Grant King, these amazing chefs, and what I've learned through them and showcasing that and having the people kind of understand that the tarts that we do create come from a place of precision, of really refined execution, but in a very approachable format. So, but also, you know, I think it would be remiss to pass up on the opportunity of making a tart. So obviously, whipped out the old Black Forest, which is actually available on the counter. Oh. Plug there, everybody. Sorry, shameless, but yeah, it's available on the counter for the next month. So yeah, it's the end of the year.
And is the blood free?
Is blood free in this one. Yeah, don't be fooled. It's actually cherry.
Gareth Whitton, congratulations, the first dessert master.
Yes.
Well won.
Congratulations. Well done. Thank you.